Wedding planning has always been stressful. And now with an unwanted guest called COVID-19, it has increased tenfold with booking venues, talking to vendors, getting refunds, etc. How do I know it's stressful?
So a month ago, I was chilling at home, being my productive self, and suddenly...
Hello people, I'm Disha and welcome to Alter Answers, the super cool page I created because I have too many questions and my fiancé said no, I'm not answering them anymore.
Hello darkness, my old friend.
So after my panic attack, I calmed down and decided to find some answers about my wedding planning, and who better to answer these questions than a wedding planner.
So the first question that I received is actually one of the most common questions I have been asked, not just from brides and grooms, but even the families of the brides and grooms. So the first question is...
Ready, contestants? Sawal aane wala hai aapke saamne aur aapka sawal raha ye.
Will the venue refund my deposit if I choose to postpone the wedding or move it to a much later date? Also, this applies to me because I booked a venue for a crowd of 1,000 plus, I think, but I can't have 1,000 plus wedding now in the near future, so I don't know what to do about that, and that is why I'm sure I'm going to have to cancel the venue. So is my venue going to refund my money? So that is the first question, and to answer this question, I have one of Mangalore's favorite planners, wedding planners, Sanjaya of Sanjaya the Planner, who's going to answer this first question for us. So over to you, Sanjaya.
Hi, Disha. In terms of refunding, I've spoken to a couple of halls and multiple venues in and around Mangalore. Since the situation of the pandemic is actually no one's fault, some of them are returning an advance that has been paid, but it obviously depends on each of their management. They may keep back some of the money as well, because we all have to understand that we have to pay employees also during this time. So it's going to help us in multiple ways. So it's always better to sit down and talk to, if you have already booked a hall or any venue, it's always better to just go directly and speak to the management.
That is great advice, Sanjaya. So guys, talking to your vendors or your venue about their cancellation or their refund policy is the best thing you can do right now. There are many ways to come to a consensus on how you can keep your deposit, not lose your deposit, and make sure that the venue doesn't lose their income as well. So that is good advice to be following right now. But since you've already booked our venue based on the guest list that we have, the number of people that we want at our wedding, what do we do now? Like, is there going to be a guest limit at the venues?
Due to the pandemic and the following lockdown, it's suggested by most of the experts in the medical field, healthcare field, that we maintain social distancing for as long as possible, and they are looking at least 1 year. So it's definitely important to keep a guest limit. Limit your guests to only very, very close friends and immediate family. And end of the day, your wedding day or your engagement day is something that you want to spend time with special ones.
That is great advice for all of you who are wondering how you're going to even have a special day without the presence of your dentist, your Zumba instructor, that one person you met somewhere at one time, or your school friends who you sent an invitation to on a WhatsApp group that you're not even active on. Guys, your wedding is about you and the people you love. So just cut down your guest list to as many as your close friends and family possible, because if you want a wedding this year, you're not going to have one with a lot of people. But if you've always dreamt of a big fat Indian wedding like the ones that happen in Hamsa Saath Hai, then go right ahead and postpone your wedding to 2021 or after. So it's your call. The next question is quite an interesting one. How do I plan the details of a wedding without losing all of my hair and money at the same time?
First, book your venue. See what venues are available. Next, go to the artist. If you have a band or you have a host, an MC, go ahead and ask them if those dates clash with them. And when you talk to the venue, get two or three dates that are available so that you can decide better with your vendors. Then next go to your decorator. I'm sure it's feasible for most decorators and lighting guys to help you out, because we can do multiple events in certain days, on certain days. So that also can be done.
So my dear pandemic brides and grooms,
don't stop believing that you can still have a magical wedding. Okay, that was lame.
Ask yourself the most important question. Can my wedding wait? If it can wait, then listen to Sansha and start talking to your planner, or get a planner and occupy yourself with the details of your wedding. Because trust me, you have nothing better to do right now, my friend. Thank you, Sansha, for helping us out with those answers. They were incredibly insightful and we could really, really use them in planning our wedding this year.
So my fellow brides and grooms, this is all we have about wedding planning in the time of Corona. If you have more questions about wedding planning, then the comment section is your letterpad, my friend. If you like this video, then you'd like our other Corona wedding related videos. I've linked them here. Please go and watch them. If you like our channel, then subscribe to it and also follow us on social media. Let's find some answers together.